People who have devoted their youth and life to drama are all gathered here at the Mecca of Korean drama, Daehangno. There is someone who always receives a warm welcome from various performances. He's Lee Yoon-taek, also known as Culture Guerrilla. Having tried out many experimental dramas, he has received recognition from audiences as well as fellow theatrical people. Now, why don't we find out more about Lee Yoon-taek's unique world of drama, which is matchless to others.
On this day, Lee Yoon-taek grabbed awards in 5 of 6 categories. After 10 years since leaving Busan for Seoul, he still has a big influence on Korean drama. After holding more than 10 vocations, he gave up everything to work on plays.
저는 혼자 사는 것보다는 사람들하고 더불어 함께 사는 게 좋아요. 그리고 혼자서 무슨 일을 하는 것보다는 사람들하고 같이 어울려서 하는 게 좋고, 연극은 세상과 직접 만나는 게 아니고 우화적으로, 상징적으로 만나게 되니까 세상에 대해서 비교적 독자적으로 얘기할 수 있겠구나. 뭐 그런 의도 때문에라도 연극을 선택했다고 볼 수 있죠.
Drama was the point of arrival in his life. Lee Yoon-taek pursued his own unique world of drama, which was making his own Korean dramatic pieces. These kinds of pieces came to represent Korea and its dramatic world and caught attention from all over the world. One of his major works was called Ogu. The premiere of Ogu was held in 1989. This was his definitive piece. Surprisingly, he completed this piece in only 2 days, which shows how sure he was of his Korean play. The story of the play Ogu is of a 78-year-old woman named Hwang, who after dreaming of her dead husband one day, says she will get married. The key word that Lee Yoon-taek used in this piece is gut. Gut is a form of shamanism that has been handed down from the ancient days in Korea.
Gut을 따라다녔죠. 왜 그랬냐면 1980년대 우리가 사용하는 문학이 이게 과연 우리 전통에 우리 인식에 맞는 문학이냐 하는데도 회의가 있었어요. 그래서 우리 걸 찾아야 되지 않겠느냐 하는 그러한 생각을 하게 됐고, 그때 이제 내가 선택한 게 연극이었고, 그 우리 게 뭐냐 하는 그 단서를 잡은 것이 굿이었어요. 그리고 또 하나는 가장 가까운 단서가 뭐냐면 우리 어머님의 화석이었다고. 교육받지 못한 할머니의 그 말, 이야기, 그리고 굿. 이런 데서 가장 한국적인 정서를 잡았고, 그러한 기반으로 나온 게 억울한 연극이었죠.
His confidence was recognized by the general mass. After its premiere, Ogu was performed for 13 years, and 2.7 million audiences came to watch his piece. And in 2003, his play Ogu was adapted into a film, in which Lee Yoon-taek worked as a film director. This is not such a surprise when we take into account all the jobs he had held, but it was still a big issue in the cultural world.
내가 만든 오그란 영화가 과연 21세기 대중사회 속에서 존재할 수 있을 것인가 없을 것인가 하는 것은 한 개인의 어떤 성패라기보다는 우리의 그 순수문화와 대중문화 그리고 문학 연극이란 것과 영화 이런 것들이 잘 만날 수 있겠는가 없겠는가 하는 대단히 하나의 중요한 시금석이 되지 않겠는가 그런 생각을 하고 상당히 긴장을 하고 있어요.
Lee Yoon-taek is a cultural gorilla who challenges things that nobody else does. Tech's early days went by in poverty. Giving up study in university due to family reasons, he makes a drama troupe in Busan. But it ends in failure.
Suga했다. 일단 얼마 안 되지만 나 놀아.
관객도 안 들어왔는데. 우리가 이 돈 받아도 되는겨.
자스가 쓸데없는 걱정하지 말고 바꾸라. 대관료는 우쩔라고 그럽니까? 뭐 어차피 이 돈으로는 대관료 택도 없다.
형 우쩔라고 얘.
The work of his passion became a failure. Not even able to pay his fees, he gives up his dream, promising himself that he would try again after 10 years. 이윤택 went on to work as a salesman, a staff in a post office, and an engineer who worked with dyes. He became a reporter, got married, and got recognition for his great editing skills. But his passion for drama never died. He started working on dramas again, where he had failed long ago in Busan, and his plays became a success. For 10 years, he worked on almost all cultural fields such as scenarios, TV dramas, films, newspaper columns, and dance productions, which were also performed abroad.
피셔리테라고 하는 독일 가장 유명한 평론가이자 평론가예요. 그분이 선물을 주셨죠. 독일에서 연극할 때 내 연극을 본 사람이에요. 윤택의 작업은 구시라고 하는 샤만, 특히 샤머니즘을 연극적 양식으로 이제 끌고 내는 아주 독특한 아시아의 작가인데 그 연극 기호가 아시아적이지 않고 대단히 현대적이다. 그러니까 우리가 소통할 수 있다 하는 그런 내용의 좋은 글을 쓰셨어요.
After his success, he has returned to the barren land of plays, a place called Midyang. Lodging in an abandoned school 4 hours from Seoul, he formed a theatrical company with other actors. Now almost 60, the only thing Lee Yoon-taek still has in his hands is his passion. And now, with other actors, he dreams of a new page in drama.
셰익스피어 시대만 해도 위로는 국왕 철학자로부터 밑으로는 시정 잡배 상인들까지 다 같이 연극을 봤다는 거죠. 서로가 계급은 다르고 서로 배운 것이 달라도 어떤 계급과 학벌과 어떤 민족까지 초월할 수 있는 모든 사람들이 한 연극을 보면서 모두 같은 공감들을 느끼고 같이 동참할 수 있는 게 연극의 미덕이 아니냐.
With the opening of a play, the audience become the actors. But at the end of it, they return to their own natural selves. But when we watch Lee Yoon-taek's plays, it is not easy to slip out of his world of imagination. That is due to the intensity and naturalness of his dramas. By expressing the unique Korean sentiments through exceptional colors, Lee Yoon-taek has become the focus of Korean drama. And now, he stands at the center of Korean drama.